Let's talk about constraints in PostgreSQL. Okay, why do we ever need constraints? Sometimes you hear stories about some online shop selling laptops for $0 or for 1 cent. It happens because of human errors or incorrectly parsed price lists, or because of lack of validation of input. It doesn't matter. There is always the possibility of error. That's why we want to protect our database. Another example. Tom has a friend named Mary. When Mary dies, we would like to remove the information of their friendship from our database, just to prevent inconsistency. But it's very easy to forget things like that. Fortunately, database can help us by itself to control that. Number one, the check constraint. Everything simple here. You just try the keyword check and any condition in brackets. In this example, we create a table with a name field that has length constraint. Even if there's a bug in your application, it's impossible to insert a user with a too short or too long name. By the way, the varchar keyword is just syntactic sugar for check constraint. Number two, domain. In PostgreSQL, you can create your own type based on a standard type, such as text or integer. And you can add some checks to it. After that, just use it as a regular type. Number three, keyword unique. In this example, we added a simple check that the email for different users must be different. However, sometimes you need to check uniqueness not for the entire table, but, for example, only for users with a certain status. For this purpose, you can use a partial unique index. Just add a condition you need in the WHERE clause. Number 4. EXCLUDE. Imagine that you need to create a table that stores some events, and these events should not overlap in date ranges. For this purpose, you can use the EXCLUDE keyword. Just write exclude using gist and specify the field and comparison operator. The using gist clause tells PostgreSQL to use gist index that will be used for fast string comparison. By the way, you may say that the unique constraint is a syntactic sugar for exclude with the equality operator. Number 5. Not null. Not null is the obvious constraint to prevent using null as a value. Be careful when adding a new not null column to an existing table. Postgres will most likely make a complete copy of the whole table, since it will have to touch every row of data. Number 6. Primary key. In PostgreSQL, primary key works as a combination of unique and not null. Number 7. Foreign key. Let's say you have a table with some status ID and another table that describes these statuses. You can tell Postgres about this connection. After that, you will be allowed to insert only ID from status dictionary table or null.